That's how insignificant they are. I didn't even care that they were here.
When?
Hey.
But when zone?
Hey.
Hey gems, it's Cindyrella LG and welcome back to my channel. So as y'all can see, I have my lovely little boys here with me today. We got Chinedu and Malik, and today we're going to be doing... You want to introduce yourselves? You guys have, like, everyone knows who you are.
What about the people that watch this?
Okay, for the people that are new. No. Okay, so today we're going to be doing the Nigerian tag. So y'all have always been asking, oh my gosh, are y'all Nigerian? And the answer is, yeah. What? Yes, we all are Nigerian. Everyone in the videos that I put in are usually Nigerian. Why do you ask? Because, I mean, I'm Nigerian and those are my friends, people I grew up with, people I've known like almost all my life. So, yeah, we're going to do the Nigerian tag for you guys today. So, yeah, with that being said, let's get right into the questions. I feel like they're still loud. I feel like I can still hear them. Alright, so as y'all can see, we had to change locations because of, some rude guests in the other rooms.
Unforeseen circumstances.
But it's okay, because... It's okay. I'm just saying, the devil will not get us down today. Okay, that's the point, right? So with that being said, let's get right into the questions. What is your Nigerian name? You wanna start?
My Nigerian name is Okwayemi.
What does it mean?
It means giving thanks to the God, like thanks saved me.
My Nigerian name is Ogechi. Well, my full name is Cindy Ogechi Machuku. And Cindy is just Cindy. Ogechi is God's time. Most of y'all have heard it in the song Ogechi, Ogechi, come on. Yeah. So God's time is always right. That's what that means. And Ogechi, come on. And my last name means God's child. Mwa means child. Chuku means God. And yeah.
And my name is Chinedu Elegonye. Chinedu means God leads us, and Elegonye means who are you looking up to?
Oh. Were you born in Nigeria?
Yeah, I was born and raised there for most of my life. We moved here in 2008, so yeah.
Back in the fall.
Yeah.
Still fresh.
I was born and raised in the Triple D. You already know it's great with goody. I'm just saying, I was not born in Nigeria.
We know.
I was born here.
Yeah, you bougie.
I'm not bougie.
I was born here also in the United States, but I'm very in tune with my Nigerian side, being the firstborn son.
Firstborn daughter.
My parents made sure I knew everything about my culture. I'm always constantly going over to Nigeria, visiting my cousins. I love seeing them every time I go over there.
Do you know more of your language than your brother does?
We all hear it. I hear it better than all of my siblings.
Same, yeah.
We're all
fluent in my family. Yeah, fluent. I need to
get going. Same. I've been working on it. What is your favorite Nigerian movie?
My favorite Nigerian movie is Wedding Party. I'm pretty sure it's a recent movie.
I haven't seen it.
What?
Yeah.
And a lot of you. And you, y'all gotta watch that. Because it's like, a lot of the Nigerian movies, they be having those like
Everything looks trash. But this one, like, this one was made properly. It was produced properly. Like, you know, people were acting well. Like, it was no.
I heard of the actors that got married in the movie got married in real life.
They did. Becky W and I forgot. Like a couple months ago, I saw that they were actually engaged. I was like, oh, that's a lot.
That's crazy. Okay, yeah. I saw that like all over, but I didn't know it was from a movie. Oh, okay, that's cool. My favorite Nigerian movie is this movie. It's old movie. It's called The Prophecy. But if y'all, my old vintage Nigerian Nollywood people will know this movie. It's one of Genevieve Nnaji's first movies where she was, she was a mother, and her husband, like they had a child, and he got possessed by like this woman that did juju on him.
Of course.
Yeah, and like she seduced him, and then the mom ended up dying, dying. Y'all know how Nigerian movies are, like very dramatic. And they turned the daughter, like the daughter went to the aunt, and they turned her into a house girl. It was bad, bro. I cried watching it, but I cried watching everything. So.
Well, my favorite movie, last you even remember a scene from it, would be in Sofia in London.
He was on the
stair area. He was chasing the pigeons, and he finally caught one. And people were just looking at him. He was in his own, like, he didn't care at all. And my tail, I was laughing so hard at this part. Like, I loved it. He got arrested. They had the pigeons and everything in the room.
Like, do you remember that part where he went up to that girl with the short skirt? What is your favorite Nigerian song? And you have to sing it. And no, I can't have the music.
That's a tough one.
Yeah.
Because there's so much.
I might have to just like go through my playlist real quick.
I got a playlist too, you know.
I have a wonderful playlist.
Me too. I be jamming that one.
Actually, the song that I really like now, like, is Give You Love by Jules and LAX.
How does it go?
I'm not gonna sing it.
You have to.
Is it Moss?
You have to. You have to.
Just a simple sentence.
Like, it's literally
for you.
Okay.
Yes. I feel to marry you.
Hey.
I feel to give you love.
Hey.
I feel to marry you. Okay, that's it. But I don't know, bro. It's a good song. It makes me feel really good. You know what I'm saying? Like, great vibes. So it's just, it's getting played on my wedding day for sure. So, you know what I'm saying?
Well, my favorite right now in this very moment.
You say my song will fight.
It's my song too, though. Like, you know, we can share that bond. You know what I'm saying, man? Like, you know what I'm saying?
What's the song?
It is right now at this very moment. Because this switches like every time.
Because I just tweeted something about this song. So
hey, this has nothing to do with you too, my friend. So don't.
But you know it's a song.
Because we talked about it earlier. That's the only reason. No, my favorite song right now is Fall by Davy Doo. I'm sorry, it's Fall by Davy Doo. And you're going, money follow you.
Pam pam,
banana follow you.
Pam pam,
brother follow you.
Pam pam,
cause I'm in love with you.
Pam pam,
money follow you.
Pam pam,
banana follow you.
Pam pam,
banana follow you.
Pam pam,
cause I'm in love with you.
Hey, now you don't talk it. Sound with me.
Yeah, I'm very basic.
rice on stew. It's undefeated.
Is there so much you can do to it?
This is my favorite.
Okay, stew. What kind of meat do you like in the stew, though?
For me, it has to be beef.
Yeah, chopped beef, right? What's your favorite? You don't say goat. Are you gonna say goat?
Chicken. Okay. I mean, chicken. It changes the complete texture.
Chicken is great.
Rice and stew is so sweet. I can eat suya like a meal. I'm talking like
that's
like a date with me in the toilet later, though. Can't lie.
You're gonna have to cop some emodium.
I love it.
I'm not gonna lie, like, alright, sidetrack. I went to Nigeria last summer and hadn't been to Nigeria in a minute. We got some kilishi and I went off on the kilishi. Like, my dad bought like 3 or 4 bags, like, you know, the newspapers, they wrap it up, whatever. And I took a whole one for myself and I smashed that hole. I'm thinking, oh, great. Like, everything's good. I'm eating. The next day, I got instant diarrhea. Like,
no, dead ass.
I felt sick. Like, I had a fever.
That was literally me last year.
Literally, like, it was the worst thing ever.
I don't know. It's because Nigerian food is very, very natural. Everything they use is like, natural. So it's like, and then that's not like how the food is here. It's very processed. So
I'm
when
scared.
You eat the food over there, it's like it just runs through you.
I'm scared to eat.
I was still tearing it up.
I can't.
Me and my cousin, when we went, we were watching the soccer match, and we walked down to the market area. I wasn't laying.
I mean, suya is okay, bro. It's kilishi, bro. Kilishi just, bro. Like, when I tell you, it was the worst experience. I've never had.
I know.
It was the worst experience. Never had that. That was my first experience.
I like my suya.
My favorite food, fried rice. And my mom's sister.
Favorite?
Stop.
Hey, you know?
You said suya. It's not even really food, it's a snack.
Honestly speaking.
Listen, can I explain it? The way my mom's sister makes it is, I don't know something about it, bro. Like, they know. I'm having flashbacks. They know when I come home and they make it that I'm finna tear it up. Like, it's gone. Like, I take some back, I bring it back with me here to school. People ask them to get some, I'm like, I ran out.
Yeah.
Still have a full thing left.
I'm not sure.
Can't share.
The fried rice has liver in it.
No, not liver. She puts gizzard meat. You can have shrimp also. Just everything is so good.
I don't like either of those.
You're sick.
Honestly,
no, sick. I don't like
no, stick with your suya.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'll stick with it.
But honestly, you can never fail me with fufu.
Egusi. Sweet. Very, very.
I'll sit there and eat it. But do you ever, have you eaten the egusi? Do you put stew in it also?
Oh, of course.
It's so good.
Yes.
I started doing it. I think I was in Nigeria and I see my uncle do it. I was like,
No one's ever done that here?
Not that I've seen.
People don't really do that.
No, my dad,
I
just never really paid much attention
like,
to it.
Like, I look at people's Snapchats and like they'll literally just have like the panadam. And like the egusi or the efo, and I just look like, damn, like that's it. Like, y'all just bought that. Nah, we put stew on everything.
I put the stew in it, and it changed it. Every time I go home, that's, I have the stew out, the egusi stew, I have the food ready.
Yeah, bro.
Put it all together. Right. And you know, there's chicken in the stew, so it's just amazing.
When was the last time you were in Nigeria, and how many times have you been?
Like I said earlier, last time I went was last summer. I was born and raised here, so. Infinity amount of time.
Last time I was there, I just got back. Last week. Yeah. How many times have I been? That was my 5th time going.
I just went this past winter break, so last year, and I've been about 4 or 5 times.
What tribe are you?
Hey man, you already know what it is, man. We out here, we Yorubas, you know what I'm saying? The best tribe in Nigeria.
So he's saying that.
Don't get it twisted.
He's saying that sitting to like two people.
He's Igbo, man.
Igbo people.
That's how we say Igbo. I didn't even say that the way.
Igbo Kwen Zonu. Hey!
As I said before, you're a bad gang.
And we're Igbo.
We're the best. You know what I'm saying?
Nobody.
Into the room. Every time I take another step, my step is bang da da bang da da.
Say something in your tribal language.
I'll just keep it simple. Bawani means, you know, how are you? You know,
That's the first thing we want to know is how to say hi.
So, you know, you meet somebody who's Yoruba, you know, the first thing you say is Bawani. Or you can say Shiowakwa, means like, are you okay? Like, are you good? Like, what's good? You know what I'm saying? So,
talk about hands, man.
Yeah.
Is that a Yoruba thing?
It's it.
What can I say? Okay. Mwoke oma na abia makagi or makam.
What does that mean?
That means a good man is coming from you.
The thing about you, like the M at the end of things, it makes it possessive.
Yeah.
So that's how you know.
Yeah.
So like that's why even girls like when you say mommy.
Mommy or obim, my heart. Obim, my heart. Mommy.
As in my own.
And then like that's why I had to correct myself when I said makagi, because that means a good man is coming for you, which is true. I must pray for myself as well. So yeah, amen. So yes, mwoke oma.
Honestly, the words I know, like, I know it, I like, but I like insults better because
we get insults each other all the time.
So I guess first I'd be like, Meshoniki, shut up, basically. Or if I really get serious, I'd be like, Motobu Kweki. And this is my parents, my mom would tell me not to say it, but it's just funny, man. Mm-hmm. It's basically little car come kill you. Moto.
That one doesn't even. That's not an insult. That's a cost.
It's a curse.
If y'all heard me say earlier, Chineke poko ago eko esu. I said God will strike you, devil. That's what that means. So,
see how aggressive.
Like cursing people is so very funny,
bro.
Like I like to say.
Insults
Iwere Ishi Otele, that means you have a head box.
Ishi Kokonat. You see? These are Igbo people.
They're strong minded.
They are friendly. Who would do that to you? Come to me.
Lie.
What was the thing you were saying to me the other day?
Huh? You're about people who cuss people out. What do you like most about Nigeria? The food?
Everything. The culture.
The culture.
The strong sense of culture that's in Nigeria. I mean, sometimes, you know, it's taken a little too far, like tribalism and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But really, like, the strong sense of culture that Nigeria has, being able to connect to that is probably what I say is my favorite part about it.
My favorite part about Nigeria, this is more about the people though, it's our pride. We have a lot of pride.
Sometimes it's
a bad thing.
No, it's not even too much. Sometimes it's too much. You can say it's too much, but it's not too much.
You get what I'm saying?
No, yeah, that's what I'm saying. You can say it's too much. But it's not too much.
Okay. So the pride in Nigerian people, we in Nigeria, man. That is what I love the most about Nigeria, or the culture, everything really. But there's a lot I don't like. So.
Not everything is perfect.
What I like the most being there in Nigeria is like everyone is like they have a sense to help one another.
That's
like,
true.
I'll see someone random, like, and I'll just say, how are you doing, uncle? Like, they're my uncle, they're my aunt. Like, it's just a sense of family. Like, we're all together, we're all one, one Africa. We're all together.
I mean, unless your name is Rojas or Good Luck Jonathan, or
you know, sometimes you think they're trying to help you, but it's
not. That's the economy for you, man. That's the government for you.
Poor people, they be falling for you.
What do you hate most about Nigeria? I was just going in. The government. That's what I was just talking about.
That's it.
The government.
No,
like, literally.
That's another thing.
What?
The roads, bro. Like,
no, damn.
That ties back to the government.
The government, because they don't want that money. It does tie back.
Like, if you see my vlog, you'll see me doing a lot of this in the car.
Because look, I didn't mind driving because I already drive fast. Like, you get used to it.
You can't do that. There's no dashes even.
If you can drive,
it's true.
I drove from Imo State to Edo State. You know what I'm saying? That is a drive.
That is a drive.
And the roads get so bad at one point.
That's like driving from Dallas to
Walker
Station.
No, it's
far. Yeah, or Houston. That is far.
I was really surprised that I was able to do it, but I did it. Like, there's a point where one man was going this way like this. That's the roads would be bad to where you'd have to switch over.
No,
going
then,
like 60 miles per hour, cars are coming, so you're going, you have to get over fast, or
you gotta watch out for the little buses. I don't know what they're called, I forgot.
Okada.
No, not Okada, but the little yellow ones without doors. You know what I'm talking about?
Keke Napep.
There we go, that's it. Do you have any Nigerian nicknames?
Well, I have one. In primary school, I was very fat. Very fat.
Insert picture here.
I was huge. So everybody used to call me Biggie Biggie.
Biggie Biggie.
Happy.
Biggie Biggie. Happy happy. Baby, do you want me?
That little boy.
Other than that, that was like the only nickname that even people I went to primary school with now that I still kind of keep in touch with, like, that's what I'm calling it. So, that's pretty much it.
My nickname is Oge or Oge Mommy. That's what my family calls me. Mostly my mom. Oge Mommy. So, that's mine.
My mom, most of she'll call me Chinedu.
My Chinedu.
And my dad.
See, now I'm gonna lie, y'all support them, okay?
My dad, he'll just say, he'll call me Nedu, which is just short for my name.
Do you speak your language?
Fluently.
I wish I was fluent.
I'm glad that I at least hear it.
I can understand well, and it's very funny because people, all those people that just thought when I'm in Nigeria, they don't think I understand what they're saying. But you people, I understand you. I'm coming for you. I understand exactly what you're saying.
It's because every time I go, like, it's like a time period where I'm not there. So when I do come back, like, they low-key forget that I'm here. So I'll just be chilling and they be talking. And they don't think that I understand what they're saying.
Exactly.
I'm like, oh, for real?
Uh-huh.
And everybody understands.
I hear you.
True. What is the most ridiculous question that you have been asked about your culture?
Do you speak African?
Ooh, I don't like that one.
How do I speak African?
Yeah.
How do you speak a continent? Tell me.
I mean, when I was in middle school, somebody asked if we had toilet paper.
No!
Yeah, I mean,
I come from Nigeria. I mean, I'm just trying to take notes in class, you know. People are trying to talk or whatever, and like, you know, they're like, oh shit, you're Nigerian, this and that. Like, people will ask me, so like, you live in the hood, this and that. The most of them, like, and then some random nigga just like, so do y'all have toilet paper? Like, what do you
mean? No, that one just hurt me. I'm not gonna lie. The most I've gotten is, do y'all like ride elephants and giraffes to school?
And I got to the point with that, like, I would say yes. Like,
yeah, same.
I ride it around town.
I'm not gonna lie.
Exactly believe I have a pet tiger, but yeah, I'm in my backyard just chilling.
I'm not gonna lie though, we did have, it wasn't a pet cow, but it was when, you know when
that's a form of
families
birds.
Come to, yeah, donate cows and stuff. Yeah, so I would feed it every day when I was younger. I thought it was my pet. And one day I was coming back from church, bro. Wow. And literally the head was off. I was like, who?
No, dead ass.
Oh my god.
I bet you still ate it though.
I did, of course. Right. Suya, what are you talking about?
Funny story, my dad is Muslim. So like we celebrate Ramadan. Mm-hmm. And we always used to get rams. Mm-hmm. Always get rams. And I was a little kid, you know what I'm saying? I'd see the ram and it'd be tied up by the tree and I'd play with it, you know what I'm saying?
Like, I thought, oh shit, the cow.
We got a pet cow every day. Bro, I would go inside and come back and all I'd see is. Bro, like the ram's head is halfway off, spilling blood, and then they start burning the body. And bro, and I'm sitting there traumatized.
Yeah, you're traumatized.
Bro,
right?
My pet,
bro, nah. I was in the States. I was a 9-year old from the States. So I was just like, bruh, Bessie gone, bro. Bessie gone. But those are all the questions that we have for this Nigerian tag. I wish it was longer, but we have fun making this video for you guys. And if you guys would like to see more of us together, and everybody else, of course, go ahead and let us know in the comment section down below. Comment your responses to all the questions with us. Let us know. We want to get to know y'all even more. We enjoyed y'all stories. I was reading a couple of the stories. Y'all are funny. Y'all are worse than us. Y'all are bad. So thank you guys so much for watching and make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you guys in the next video and stay blessed and beautiful, gems. Bye.